Thank you for joining us. We have some really important announcements, a couple of subjects that we wanted to cover today, and some of the amazing things that are occurring even in these challenging times, and then also talk about a reopening plan that we've developed to reopen the church for members to be coming on a Sunday and worshiping again here at Emmanuel. So let me go over some of the things that are occurring in our congregation, even during these challenging times. Pastor Stanton has continued to provide us great leadership in his role. And going forward, we will have Pastor Mueller on Monday nights doing our services on Monday nights, and then Pastor Stanton is working with the district office to provide another pastor to work with Pastor Stanton, because as we open up services, we'll need the additional pastoral support. Barry Weber is working with the call committee. They're shifting from an associate to do some preliminary work on the senior pastor call. So if you have names or suggestions, you can forward those to the church office or Barry Weber directly. The music team continues to do an amazing job supporting our live streaming and supporting our efforts of our services, and we appreciate all that work that's being done. Your church council continues to work behind the scenes, working on the budgets for next year, working on some of the mission areas, and making sure that we're supporting things correctly and providing a future opportunity and looks that we have as we open up and reopen our congregation. And the child care has done something really amazing with the CARES Act and some of the resources that we're able to pull in. The child care opened up in the first week of May, providing free services to first responders and essential workers. Really a blessing that we've been able to give to our community. We thank the child care workers. I know it's a little uncomfortable, but they've done an amazing job. If you enter the front of the church, you'll see that as you enter the building, there is a food drive that's occurring. And Heather Ball, Karen Isaacson, and Mary Todd Krieger are working on that. And I mentioned their names just if you have questions, you can reach out to them. But we're raising food for the food pantries and those in need. And the shut-ins and the seniors in our congregation, some of them are harder hit. Jackie Tretton and Mary Todd Krieger are doing a lot of personal work there with a team. And if you want to provide some assistance there, it'd be a wonderful opportunity to support our seniors and support our shut-ins. We continue to do some amazing work with our children in the school, obviously, with virtual activities that are occurring. We continue to educate. Sharon and AJ do a great job along with the teachers in that effort. And lastly, in some of the amazing things that are occurring here, our office staff continues to operate. You've seen sort of a seamless operation between Kim and Maggie and reaching out into our congregation in those efforts. So what I'd like to do is shift just a few minutes to the reopening. We want to make sure first that it's first and foremost that it's safe for those that are coming. And so we've built out a schedule. Right now we have a tentative date to open on June 13th and 14th and 15th, which is the Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. The services will be as follows. Saturday night will be at 5 p.m. That's what you're used to. On Sundays, they will stay even for the summer season at 8 and 10:30. And the reason we have that separation is because we need about an hour to clean and disinfect to make sure that the next group coming is safe. And then on Monday at 7 p.m., a couple of things that we will do and try to protect. We will have about 50 people in the sanctuary. We feel that's the safe number. Then we will have two other locations in the fellowship hall and the gym that will take an additional 50 people. So that gives us enough social distancing to protect those individuals that are worshiping at these services. We will honor and try to protect the social distancing, so you're all comfortable with that already. Families will set together, individuals will set with the proper distancing accordingly. There will be no hymnals or Bibles or pencils in the pews, and so If you should bring your own Bible, we'll have hymnals, but we'll only use them, and then we'll set them off to the side to disinfect them. Envelopes, offering, attendance will all be dropped in a box when you arrive, so that way there's no handling and contact between individuals. One of the things that we worked out with Pastor Stanton is the proper use of communion. We will have communion. We will take in some distancing and protective concerns there to make sure that people that are coming are comfortable. But it's important that we get started back in fellowshipping together. We will encourage you to wear masks. It isn't going to be required. We might separate rooms in those wearing and not. We haven't decided, but we want to make sure everyone attending is comfortable. There will be a children's sermon, but it will be in the pews. Again, children sometimes might not be as comfortable in understanding that distancing that we're looking. And one of the things that council made the decision, you'll see some upgrades in the live streaming. This has been sort of a revealing to council and to others. We're going to enhance our ability even beyond this event that we're having in the world today, and we're going to continue live streaming in the future. So if you're on vacation or if you're not feeling well, you'll be able to watch live streaming of Emmanuel services in the future. Your feedback and your thoughts on this are important. Please reach out to the church office or myself via email, but we would be happy to provide some additional feedback. But we look forward to seeing you on the week of June 13th and 14th. Thank you very much.